أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. السلام عليك يا أبا عبد الله وعلى الأرواح التي حلت بفنائك. قال سيدنا ومولانا الإمام حسن بن علي العسكري عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام: شيعة علي هم الذين لا يبالون في سبيل الله أوقع عليهم أو وقعوا على الموت. How do we define death? Some school of thoughts come and they define death and they say death is the end. It's the end of a man and woman physically, mentally, spiritually. They die and dies with them their legacy, their name. Others, they come and they say, death is the beginning. It's a beginning for an eternal life. It is a beginning for a life that is going to be an eternity, either in inferno or an eternity in paradise. When it comes to the companions of Imam al-Husayn alayhi al-salati wa salam, following their leader, Abu Abdullah al-Husayn, they saw death as something sweet. We are dying for what is going to be at the greatest revolution of mankind. Abu Abdullah al-Husayn himself said, لا أرى الموت إلا سعادة والحياة مع الظالمين إلا برمة. I see death, nothing but beauty, nothing but end of this life, and living with the tyrants and the oppressors, for me, it's worse than death itself. When it comes to others, the companions of Imam al-Husayn, one of them being his son, Ali al-Akbar, this young lad, when he saw his father upon entering the land of Karbala, Imam al-Husayn, for a moment, he closed his eyes, and then when he opened them, he was in a status of fear. So he looked at him, Ali al-Akbar, and he said to his father, oh father, I see you as something is occupying your mind. What's going on? He said, this is the land of Karbala. And he pointed to Karbala al-Muqaddas. And in this land, we will be massacred. And your family members, your aunties, your sisters will be taken captive. So Ali al-Akbar looked at his father and he said, oh father, ya abatah, hal nahnu ala al-haq? Are we on the right path? He said to him, he replied, qala bala. Qal falam nubali, aw waqa'a al-mautu alayna, aw waqa'na ala al-maut. If we are on the right path, it doesn't matter for us to go to death or death comes to us. Zuhair ibn al-Qayn comes and he says to Shimr. Shimr was standing there and he was chanting and he was screaming that these are the companions of Umar ibn Sa'd. This massive army of 30, 40,000 soldiers are here to spill your blood. Zuhair said to him, oh man, you're trying to scare us from death. Dying with Hussein for us is sweeter than living without him. Living without Abu Abdullah al-Hussein for us, it's darkness. And we want to sacrifice ourselves for the cause of Abu Abdullah al-Hussein, salamullahi alayhi. Another example of this is the example of Qasim ibn al-Hasan alayhi afdhalus salati was salam on the eve of Ashura, when they were sitting in the tent, the companions of Imam al-Husayn, his family members, and the Imam was telling them of what will happen on the day of Ashura. Qasim, a 13-year-old lad, when the Imam finished his speech and his conversation with the companions, he stood up and he said, Ya Ammah, hal ana fi man yuqtal? O uncle, am I also going to be killed on the day of Ashura? The Imam Salamullah alayhi, he looks at him and he says to him, Ya Qasim, O Qasim, كيف الموت عندك? How do you define death? Bear in mind, Qasim ibn al-Hasan is a 13-year-old lad. And every 13-year-old today, if you ask them, he tells you, or she tells you, I'm looking forward to uni, I'm looking forward to get married, to have the best work I can have, buy this car, buy this condo, travel to this country, to this city, to this village. They have dreams, they want to achieve them when they are older. But Qasim ibn al-Hasan looks at his uncle and he says these words that made history. He says to his uncle, Ya am fi nusratika ahla min al-asad. For me, dying for you is sweeter than honey. Brothers and sisters, when it comes to being a companion of Sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman, Imam al-Hujjah alayhi afdhalu salati wa salam, we have to follow the example of the companions of Imam al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi. The example of the companions of Imam al-Husayn are the best examples. They are the role models for every man and woman that are trying to become companions of the Imam of our time, Imam al-Hujjah alayhi afdhalu salati wa salam. They had many characteristics that others that did not possess. One of them was this: they were not afraid of death because they knew that they are dying for something that is bigger than history itself. That is the legacy of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn, Nahdhat al-Husayn, the message of Aba Abdullah al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi. So they came on the day of Ashura and they gave their lives, and their life in this world ended, and in the next world the life started. But bear in mind, their life physically in this world ended, but their message continues. 1381 years after their death, their martyrdom, we remember them. When they died on the plains of Karbala, they became immortals and they achieved immortality with Imam al-Husayn salamullahi alayhi. Assalamu ala al-Husayn wa ala Ali ibn al-Husayn wa ala awlad al-Husayn wa ala ashab al-Husayn.